And now,
the Canadian national champion, Brian Orser, pacing backstage. We'll be back with his performance.
Brian Orser, Canada.
The Olympic silver medalist behind Canada. Scott Hamilton. Canadian Brian Orser, 23 years old, who was third entering the long program. A lot of people thought that he was a sure bet for the gold. But along came Alexander Fadeev, along came Josip Sobotchuk, and it's been a fight.
He's had a rough time here, but this is his event. This is what he won at the World Championships last year and the Olympic Games. And it's technically as difficult as Alexander Fadeev's. His opening move is a triple lutz jump. Double tolu. Jump. Oh, and he hangs on. Nice jump. Double loop, but the double loop was a single loop.
Watching Canadian Brian Orser, and really in his perennial pursuit for a gold medal, which has eluded him for so long, first you were standing in his way, and now Fadeev. As I mentioned, a lot of people thought that he was a sure bet for gold.
Onto that one too. He came in here the heir apparent, which is a tough situation when you've never really won the medal, to wear it around your neck for a year and then come here with the pressure of repeating.
You know, Scotty, watching Brian Orser in this year's Worlds in Tokyo and comparing the performance to last year's in Canada, he doesn't seem to have the spark here.
Yeah, he doesn't seem to be performing at his best emotionally tonight. The spark, the electricity around his performance isn't there.
Remember, the judges are reacting to not only what they see, but what they feel.
He's going to try something that really hasn't been done. He's going to try to repeat a triple S jump. No, it's a double. You can see the men around this point in their long program, they start to get a little fatigued. Their shoulders come up a little bit and their arms sag, and their jumps seem to be a little bit looser in the air. You're so tired to pull a triple toe at the end of your program. Shows a lot of stamina.
franchise in men's figure skating. Brian Orser, been the Canadian national champion 6 years running. And what do you think, Scotty? Was that the gold medal performance he was looking for?
Well, I've seen him skate a lot better technically, but the main thing tonight is I think that the emotion, the electricity, really wasn't around his performance like it was last year. Here we're going to see a replay of the triple axel. He really gets great height on this jump. He throws it straight up into the air, but right here it starts to tilt backwards, right there. See how tilted it is? It takes a lot of strength to be able to pull this out on a running edge. See? It's a great effort.
So now Orser waiting for his scores. That's going to be brutal, all that waiting.
You know, you work all year for this event, and then it's over, and maybe things could have gone better. It's just a real helpless feeling.
So all in the hands of the judges now. The first set of scores, again, will be from nine judges from nine different countries. First scores will be for technical merit. And as they come up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 8 are the highs. But look at this, the Canadian and the United States judge, Scotty, both gave Orser 5-6.
And 5-6 is below both Boitano and Fadeev.
So Orser, based on these scores, really with no chance to catch Alexander Fadeev, who is in first place at this point, will still wait for the artistic impression scores. But what's interesting here, Scotty, is the low of 5-6 that was given by the Canadian judge.
Those are nowhere near the marks he got last year.
Here they come, artistic impression. These scores are much better. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9s. The high score of 5-9 was not given by the Canadian judge. He gave a 5-7, so Brian Orser will not catch the Soviet Alexander Fadeev. Fadeev is assured the gold medal, but silver and bronze are still up for grabs. Right now, let's go down to John Misha Petkovic, who's with Brian Orser.
Well, what do you think?